Hello Connections, my name is Omkar Moria and I have got a capstone project by Gobi regarding to Twitter scraping. Here some skill sets are required like Python scripting, data collection, MongoDB, Streamlit, etc. This is a social media domain and by using an SNS script, creating a data frame and collected collection of data into the MongoDB. By using Streamlit, I have to create a web app and my motto of this project to scrape data, specific date and timing, scraping of data, any length of data, and can be uploaded in MongoDB. So let's check our code, which are already I have done that. So I have to install all these Python libraries like pip install, streamlit, pip install, panda, pip install, snscrape, and pymongo. So let's install all these Python libraries in local machine. So it took some time. Then again I install pip install. Pandas. So again pip install snscrape. And next pip install pymongo. After installing all these libraries, I would like to go to run like Streamlit, import pandas, import snscrape, import pymongo from Python library. Here I have to scrape data of Elon Musk from of 15 February 2023 up to till now date. And here is my data frame I have created. And there is a creation of Streamlit using app, web app, and some buttons like keywords, start date, end date, and the limit of the data by slide bar using a slider. So here is the limit of 1000 data which can be scrapped from Twitter. So I have created a heading of the web app like Twitter scrapper. So this is scraping Twitter data using keyword, date and time, and creating buttons of upload to MongoDB, and creating buttons of downloading CSV and JSON files, and also different formats like CSV and JSON can be downloaded easily and uploaded to MongoDB. So here I can run these all programs. So click here on the run button, and now you can check the code which cannot be run in this terminal. So here are some code provided by it. To I would like to go copy paste it, and here I get this code: Streamlit run C users Omkar VS code twitter.py. I copy that code and paste on my command prompt. So this is my command prompt, and I have paste my code here and press enter, and this will be continued directly to the my Chrome. Here my web app will be open. Here the my first page dashboard. Here I am using scraping my Elon Musk data. So I write here the hash Elon Musk, and the date I have required, from which date does I have to scrap the data. So I created a limit from which amount of data I have to scrap. So that's here the app is running, you can check it, and now it takes some time to scrap all the Twitter data, about 1000. So take some minute. Now it is done. Here my data frame has been created about Elon Musk Twitter data. Here date, ID, URL, and here the button upload to MongoDB. I have click on that, and here an option to download the file in CSV either JSON format. So it's take time to upload to MongoDB. After uploading, I will show you here MongoDB files can uploaded to the my MongoDB. Here Elon Musk data. I have uploaded that 3 times, so there is it shows 3K documents, 3000 documents. Here all the data saved in JSON format. Let's here the keywords which I have entered. Here any username can be entered, like Omkar, Omkaraka. So also it shows the same scraping of the data. It this web app is used to scrap any user ID from which any date, any of the starting date, any of the end date, any of the limit of the data. So it can be used to scrap about millions of data also. So it can be saved to MongoDB also. I have shown earlier. So the benefit of the this web app is to scrap data, any type of data, any time of data. From this project like this, I have learned several things like web scraping techniques using Python and building simple web apps using Streamlit. Some other challenges: handling potentials, error, missing data, authentication error. One improvement that could be made in future: to implement natural language processing to analyze content of the tweets in more detail. Additionally, consider adding more advanced data visualization techniques such as interactive charts to enhance the user experience on web app. Implementing real-time streaming of Twitter data using Twitter API, or deploy the web apps to a cloud platform such as Heroku, AWS and Netlify. So this is my project. Thanks for watching.